Hello, everybody. So, I'm playing with the Mongols and I have only culture victory and domination victory enabled. And we are playing Warlord. I believe it's not. It's not settler, but it's the or maybe prince. Yes, I think it's default difficulty level. So we're playing prince, and against 16 opponents. I wiped out two opponents, the Khmer and the Germans. So the Germans were super easy. And the Khmer put a little bit more resistance because they had some catapults and walls, but once I got my trebuchet, and also I got a early trebuchet corps thanks to a general, it was fairly okay from that moment on to conquer all those cities. So now I'm allied with the Scotland against England, and I'm also waging war against Stockholm. Because Stockholm basically has pissed me off because it's built the pyramids, the great library, the oracle, and was playing pretty strong. So rushing towards science, and it's got the first unit that I see from the Swiss is this lonely Carolean. And I'm quite happy to see them because the first three Swedish city, Gothenburg, Örebro and Stockholm, they pose absolutely no resistance whatsoever. They have walls and that's it, but it was open field all around. They posed absolutely no resistance. So what this I think is also another way to see this problem, where the AI basically thinks that its cities are safe without any military unit. So the capital of Stockholm, you could imagine being surrounded by units. It was already pretty in a good defense position with mountains, ranges all around, and really snaky path to reach the targets. But no, what they had is just one lonely Carolean. So this is really unacceptable from the AI, but I think this is part of a bigger problem. It's a bigger problem. Who's fired me? Oh, I'm at war with Robert Bruce. Oh, I was aligned with him, and now he's against me. Right. I thought we were friends, Robert. You betrayed me. That's no good. By the way, Bruce AI was quite intelligent in spreading out a little bit its second city, and then its third city, he's built it up 1x distance. But take a look at London, is the second city, is Birmingham, is a 2x cities. Maybe there's a third city down there, I don't know. How many cities does London has? But look at Canada. Look here. This is Prince. Remember, this is Prince. It's fairly easy. And look at Canada. It's got 8 cities. Its capital has got 3 wonders. The Great Bath, Statue of Zeus, and Etemenanki. It's got Caesar Square, it's got campus, university, it's got everything. And yet, has built almost all the city to 1x distance. Ottawa, Toronto 1x, Montreal 1x, or 2x is St. John, 2x is Quebec City, and then 1x, 1x, and again 2x for Winnipeg. It's so cramped. 8 cities, so cramped. But I like it. I like it. It's more, it looks more natural. weeks. It's more widespread. It's got the three cities, one X and three axes. The second one, and also the Greeks. I think this is Alexandria, Macedonia. There, one X. Each one. Then there is Babylon, which of course has university everywhere. And I should plant a spy in Babylon soon enough. Then we have Brazil, with cities at 1x distance. And then we have the Maya over there, and somewhere there is Mapuche, and where is it? Yeah, there is there's someone else they haven't yet discovered. Anyway, I finally got my caciques. Just keep turn there. What are you doing? Increases trade routes by 2, and I have no city states. I don't like city states, so no city states in my game. And also just 2 religions, so I wiped out the Buddhism, and now there is only my religion left in the game. And that's it. That way I can get some money. So it's, I got 3 goals for each city, and that way I can collect some money and sustain this not really huge army, but it's expensive anyway. Oh damn it. So we are bombarding London, and the Carolean are super strong at 70. As you can see, but there's no, basically there is no units. There's just that one. Where's you? You got this playground and tourney ground. Let's build this tourney ground stuff. Bruce can stay there. Move these guys up front. And yeah, what's the problem here with why I made this this video? Because I want to show that the AI doesn't build any units. And yeah, I don't understand why. It's super strong, it's built universities and wonders all around. It's a super strong, unique unit. And what happened? It denounces me because I didn't denounce Sweden. Sweden denounced me because I wiped out Germany. Everybody is. Has denounced me for some stuff I don't understand, I don't care. Everybody denounced me. I think I'll be able to survive this another Carolean charge. Because it's really strong. Caroleans are really strong. But the problem for the Swedes is they won't have time to defend themselves if they continue not building any units. Completely and utterly pointless. Should I keep this city? Or does she has nothing? She has nothing. Vastaras. Should I keep Vastaras? Or no? I'm not keeping it. I have too many cities already. Get some more gold, please. So I could leave the Sweden alive and go after Babylon. London is gonna fall this turn. And again, London, England hasn't built a single unit. A single unit, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Maybe Sweden will be able to keep a city with that tiny unit. London would like peace treaty. Yeah, let's go, girl. Are you happy? Fine, beat some units. Piss off.
And first Hephaestus.
I don't believe London will be able England will settle new cities. Or maybe she will declare war again. We got Manchester down here, so England was 4 cities. Now, where are you going? No way, no way. you asking why? The strongest player by culture with Canada and Babylon is the strongest by technology, but technology is disabled, so it's not going anywhere. But doesn't know any other kind of victory. And that is what she'll do. Just focus on science, no matter what. I'm sorry, Swift, but you get only one city left. And it's not going to last for very long. It's not going to last for very long. So what we got here, instantly create a bombard unit. And here we have a catapult, and here is Renaissance and industrial and era units. So we are gonna use this guy. While this guy here was good for classical and medieval era movement, if I upgrade to bombard, I will need that guy to move faster. So I'm sorry, Sweet, but this is your last turn.
A diplomatism.
And Sweden hasn't built anything more than that single Carolean unit. Knowingly that
the temple is surrounded by a moat.
He's gonna die. No matter what, you're gonna die. Completely unable.
Jag älskar
to defend its cities. Completely unable to defend its cities. Should I keep Karstad or just raise it? I keep it. And now it's time for Babylon. Babylon boy. Yeah. You're gonna die. You're gonna die. And that's it. So my next threat is Canada. But you see, now that Sweden is gone, my next threat is Canada, but it's not much of a threat more than the Maya, the Mapuche, or even England and culture. Score, I'm 3 times the score of anyone else. Domination, obviously, I have 4 capitals, and we are 1280 AD, and our army is pretty strong. I really hope that this Anglo-Saxon wing here could unite with the Canadian wing and exploit this land over here and build something, because otherwise the world is mine. The world is mine, and I'm gonna annihilate Babylon. Oh, just build the Colosseum? Babylon just build the Colosseum? Whew! One more reason to bring this baby down. And I don't care what you think. Your problem is that you have absolutely no units whatsoever. Same as Sweden. Absolutely no unit whatsoever. Look at this. Not a single unit, not a single unit. Oh, now we have a unit.
Whatever is contrary to nature.
Where are you going? Now what? Am I at war with someone else? No, I'm not at war with the guy there. With Mapuche, so what do you want? Doesn't understand what does he want from me? But it's nice to see at least some force. Amenity. Extra gold, what was we have gold? No, let's use a little bit more gold. And what about here? We have 1, 2, 3 kashiks. Four, five. There's a knight over there. Couldn't kill me. Pretty dead. no opposition, completely rudimentary tactics, like there's really no tactics at all. Just like I don't care. What's going on? There's nothing really to worry about. They put up walls, and that's all there is. That's really not much else. The AI doesn't build any unit. There's not much it can do to defend. Yes, I'm strong.
Not all who want.
Yes, I'm strong, but too easy. They're too stupid. They cannot defend themselves, and they will not build an army it. this is the this was the strongest civilization opponent in the game. I don't know. They look so dumb. They look so stupid. And their only defense is the strength of the city. They're absolutely.
Thus, it is necessary.
And it's
to know
boring. It's boring because there is no. The AI will not think about building necessarily. An army this way, because all of our defense tactics will orbit around
it is necessary for the one who fell.
The building walls, and that's it, and then it's just another building, and that's all. There's nothing else, and that's so boring. That's so boring. There's nothing else to say. I think for this video was already too long, so I don't wanna bore you guys. This was the second part of the Mongols against the world. We're gonna wipe out the Babylon in by next turn. So I hope you enjoyed. This is as I said also in the other thread. Too many buildings. This approach leaves the AI basically with no choices, because it's just too easy. To just build walls and hope no one comes. But it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen.
In a dusty, bustling claims that come.
Someone will come. And we'll take advantage of this stupid AI. Goodbye, Babylon. It was fine knowing you. But it was more fine that you are to know you are no more. And with this, I say goodbye to everyone. Have a nice evening, have a nice play, and let's hope this city building defense system will be abandoned for good. Cheers.